you see there, Lukey?
Well, I see we have Horse Trail North.
Yep.
Rhododendron Trail.
Yep, which we're on.
Wise Shelter, two miles.
Yep, that's northbound on the Appalachian Trail.
And Thomas Knob Shelter, 3 miles southbound on the Appalachian Trail.
Southbound, also known as SOBO. That is where we are heading, everybody. Welcome to the Outdoor Gear Review. My name is Luke. His name is Luke. We are about to hop on the Appalachian Trail for a multi-day adventure. 2 nights, 3 days. Oh yeah, father and son. Over 30 miles. We have some work to do.
Yes.
We are in Virginia at Grayson Highlands. This place is amazingly beautiful. For those of you who live in Montana or have been to Montana, you may say this looks like home or looks very familiar. And that's because this part of the country here looks just like Montana, certain parts of it. Now, I have been to Montana and it's very, very close.
What you doing there, Lukey?
I am taking this off. It is hot.
Yes, it is.
Yeah.
Whew. All right. Water break. Lucas is taking some clothes off. I'm going to fire up the GPS unit just so I can record the trek. That's something that I like to do personally when I'm out backpacking. I record the treks so I can look back onto them later. I could see the elevation gained and lost. It's pretty cool. Now, of course, I do have some paper maps, which I will show you all that stuff later on. Right now, just stopping here for just a minute. Currently going southbound on the AT, we are heading to Thomas Knob Shelter. For the first night, we're going to take it pretty easy. We have about 2 hours until sundown, so we figured we'd get, I don't know, 3-4 miles in.
Yeah.
Camp out on top of the bald. Oh my gosh. Wake up with like the best sunrise ever.
Oh, it'll be great.
Yeah, dude, it's going to be so good.
Yeah.
I'm so excited.
Me too.
Haven't seen any of our friends yet. Hopefully soon.
What do you think so far, bud?
It's awesome.
Yeah?
Yeah. It's super pretty out here.
Gosh, yeah.
Yeah.
Special spot. Check this out.
We were hiking along here, and Lukey, he noticed something. There is a wildfire out this direction. Check this out.
So you guys can see, starts right about there at the dip of that mountain range. See all that smoke? And it clears out.
That is a substantial fire.
Yeah.
That's a big one. Good eye, my friend, good eye.
Yeah.
I see one of our friends, dude. I cannot believe that it's February. It's like 65 degrees up here. That is insanity.
Yeah. It's not right.
It's not right. Helicopter. I think this guy in the helicopter here is learning how to fly. What do you think?
Yeah, he's doing all sorts of turns and stuff.
Yeah, he's just kind of flying in circles.
Yeah.
Kind of figuring it out.
Time for another circle.
Welcome to the Mount Rogers National Recreation Area. We will be following the white blazes for this trip. 3 miles to Mount Rogers. Appalachian Trail, let's go.
All right.
Hey, buddy. Cool hair, huh?
Yeah.
Looks like rock star hair.
Can I go pet?
Probably shouldn't.
Yeah,
if he comes up to you, you can pet him. Otherwise, don't.
Pony?
Now, with the ponies here, do not feed them. If you do, you turn them into terrorists. They will bother you, torment everyone nonstop. Yep. Say hi, don't pet, don't feed. These are wild ponies, but they are taken care of somewhat. Essentially, they mow this place. They keep the trails, everything mowed up.
Oh, yeah?
By eating all the grass.
Ooh.
Ooh.
It's a little steep, eh?
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, but gosh, it is beautiful.
It's so pretty. Look at that.
Uh-huh. Wow.
This is cool, guys. very rocky, out in the sun.
Yeah.
As it's going down.
Logie, you are at 5,217 feet right now.
Seriously?
Yeah.
Gosh.
Beautiful.
High up.
This trip is pretty ambitious. Over 30 miles. We want to get this done in about 2 days. Typically, you would get this done in about 2.5 to 3 days.
Ooh, yeah.
Yeah.
This is definitely a different sort of landscape than from where I'm from, so.
Yeah.
It really is cool. The fact that we could camp out anywhere we want to, that's pretty sweet. Need some water?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
This guy right here is going to sleep good tonight.
Yeah.
You're working for it, aren't you?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's not easy. We are going to keep going this direction here. We're going to go up through here, go around this mountain, and eventually make our way around, start heading south.
This is the southbound direction. Going downhill most of the way is going to make this awfully sweet.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm ready for it.
Gosh. Amazing.
Yeah.
This reminds me of my days backpacking in Montana. Also, when I was driving across the country in a U-Haul, pulling Grammy's car.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Huh. I hit up some really awesome places on that trip. So, there's a trail right over here, and that will take you to the top of this mountain. But that is not the direction we are headed.
There's a little bit of snow left on the ground from the previous storm. We have the Wilburn Ridge right up here. As you can see, there's the sun. We have about an hour or so before it goes down. All right, so that is where we are headed. Oh yeah, nice and steep, pal.
Woo, yeah.
Yeah.
Put a hand up there and climb your way up.
Great.
All right. Cool.
Yeah.
Up here we'll stop, take a break, Okay. Check the map, get some water. Okay. Definitely be careful.
Huh?
It is. You're making it look easy though.
This is crazy.
That's our path over there.
Yeah.
Carries on. We are at the top of the Wilburn Ridge. Very cool.
Yeah.
We just passed a hiker back there. He's basically doing some practice runs. He has his backpack full of weights, about 25 pounds, and he's just strengthening his legs for a hike from Grayson Highlands down to Damascus. The same hike that we're doing, he's going to do it next month. He said at the Thomas Knob Shelter, which we're coming up upon here in a little bit, there's already through hikers there, so the place is packed. What the heck?
Why?
Golly, already.
Yeah.
That's amazing. It's really, really early.
Yeah.
But the weather's so nice, why not?
Yeah.
Basically here to chill for a second. Mm-hmm. Keep carrying on.
The trail continues. That's where we're headed. Taking a look at the map here, this is where we started. And we are right here in the middle. Right here. We'll keep carrying on, figure out a place to camp. Oh yeah. Thank you. Whew, how's that elevation been treating you?
Whew, it's hard.
Yeah?
Yeah.
We are 5,500 feet.
Huh. Not bad.
We've done 3 miles so far, buddy.
Oh, cool. Yeah.
That's been a slow 3 miles with this elevation gain that we've had to do here. But that's okay.
Yep.
It's part of the game.
Mm-hmm.
Once we get over this, once we get past Pine Mountain, we'll really start going downhill after that, on our way to White Top.
Wow. That's amazing, buddy.
That's crazy. So pretty.
That right there is Pine Mountain.
That's us?
Yep, 2 miles to Mount Rogers.
Is that where we're going?
That's where we're headed, buddy. Yeah.
Yeah.
Within 2 miles or so, we'll camp.
Yeah.
How's that sound to you?
Sounds good.
Sound good?
Yeah.
Let's shake hands on it. Yeah.
Maybe we should shake like gladiators. What do you think?
I could do that.
All right. Whew. Oh, yeah. Gladiators don't shake hands.
Yeah.
As we're hiking along here, I have this country song stuck in my head. And it's one of these songs where I kind of like it, but then again, at the same time, like the lyrics to it are ridiculous. So it's about this guy. The song is like Still Riding Shotgun, I think. The song says that his wife gets mad when he doesn't pay the bills on time. And first off, I was like, what the heck? I would be raging mad if somebody didn't pay the bills on time because that affects your credit. So here the guy is, he doesn't pay the bills on time and he's like ruining their credit. I would be angry too. But then it goes on to say that like he just treats his wife or his girlfriend, whatever it is, like crap. Basically, it goes on to say that like he just takes advantage of her the entire time, that he just keeps pushing her, but yet she's not gonna leave him. It's just a really weird song.
What'd you think about that song?
It's not bad. Yeah. I'm not into country, but it's bizarre. I don't know why you'd sing about that.
Yeah, but he talks about like putting her down.
Yeah.
And like chewing her out. Like he like she'll put up with like all of like the nasty things that he says to her.
Yeah.
It's weird.
Yeah. It's a bizarre song.
It is. Lucas is still riding shotgun. He'll be doing it for the long run.
Yeah.
That's not how the song goes.
Yeah.
Guys, look at that. Oh, man. Look at that sunset.
That is gorgeous.
Yeah.
Freedom, Lukey.
Yeah.
Wow. Okay, so a heads up on what we're doing. We are now looking for a place to camp. We're going to stop basically right before we get to Thomas Knob's shelter. Since it's packed tonight, we're just going to find a spot away from that. We will refill our water tomorrow. There's a water source behind Thomas Knob's shelter. We want to camp out on top of the bald here, but we need to find a spot that's a little bit sheltered from the wind. Being up top, it's a little bit breezy. So I'm thinking like down here somewhere.
All right, Mr. Lucas, where are we, bud?
We are at our campsite.
Yes!
Yeah!
Folks, we have found a beautiful spot. Check this place out.
Nice and flat. Nice fire pit for the boy.
Yeah!
Oh, yeah. Perfect.
All right, not going to waste any time. Going to set up the tent. Bring you guys back in just a minute.
All right, folks, so camp is set up. Check out this incredible tent. I do need to take care of the ground sheep, but I'll do that in just a minute. This is our 1 pound tent. It's wild, isn't it? This is the Sierra Designs Mojo UFO tent. Cuban fiber materials, carbon fiber poles. 1 pound with actual tent poles, not hiking sticks. That's pretty incredible. Oh yeah. What is for dinner tonight, buddy?
We are eating some nice spaghetti.
Mountain House spaghetti.
Yeah.
Gosh, yeah. Dude, that's going to be so great.
It is. I'm so excited.
Heck yeah.
Yeah.
Guys, holy crap. That might be the most beautiful thing I've ever seen, dude.
Yeah.
What do you think, buddy?
It's awesome. Look at that. It's so red.
Look at that. Oh, man.
Wow.
Wow, that's beautiful, buddy.
Yeah.
Man, thank you so much for coming on this trip.
Yeah, thanks for taking me. Day one.
Oh, yeah, day one.
Day one in the bag.
Yep.
Yep. Dinner's cooking right now. Mountain House spaghetti. Oh, yeah. Gosh. It's going to be so great. So great.
Yeah. It's going to be awesome.
Yeah. It's starting to get cold.
Yeah.
A little bit.
I'm pretty chilly.
Yeah, it's in the 40s right now. It'll be low around 30 degrees. By morning. The winds are blowing about 10 miles an hour up here. Sadly, we couldn't gather enough firewood before it got dark to have a fire, so
yeah.
Yeah. It'll be a fireless night, and that's kind of what I planned on, to be honest with you. Yeah.
Wow. Yeah.
Beautiful, buddy.
Uh-huh.
Well, let's go back and talk to the folks for a little bit.
All right.
Tell them about our adventure coming up.
Yeah.
Guys, to tell you more about this adventure. Woohoo! Yeah, 3 days. Monday, Tuesday, finish on Wednesday. From what I understand, we're looking at right around like 35 miles. And we've put in, right at 4 miles today. And we got a late start, best that we could. So over the course of 2 days, Tuesday and Wednesday, we are really going to have to push. Tomorrow will be the big push day.
Yeah.
Yep. Our plan is to basically go to bed as soon as we get done eating and get up as the sun comes up around 7.
Yeah.
Yeah. We'll have a nice good breakfast, scrambled eggs, hash browns, bacon. Oh, it's going to be sweet.
Yeah.
Yeah. Enjoy some coffee, some energy chocolate to get us going.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yep. And then it's push. It's hammer time. We got to go.
Yep.
Now, tomorrow night, they say that rain is coming in. So it's going to rain Tuesday night. It's going to like light rain, spotty Wednesday. Yeah. I think we should be in pretty good shape. Being inside of the canopy of the forest here, it's not going to be too bad, but we do have our rain gear just in case we need it. Temperatures are going to be great. We're looking at in the 60s.
Wow.
Yeah. Low 30s at night, 40s, depending on which night we're talking about. It's going to be...
Yeah.
Yeah. Great. It's going to be great.
Yeah.
Yep. Yep. How's that food feel?
Feels warm. Feels great. Yeah, take it.
Oh, yeah, buddies. Okay. Got to open this up. Make sure it's all stirred up nice and good. It will be interesting to see if we wake up with some pony action because there is pony poop everywhere.
Yeah.
Mountains of it.
Yeah.
It's unbelievable. Oh, man.
Is it better?
Mm. You should take your spoon and try by that.
Okay.
I think it's go time. This is a trip that I've wanted to do for a long time. I was able to work it out, and Lucas was able to come with me. Yeah! Super awesome. Originally, my evil twin, Ira, he was going to come along. But we couldn't work out the dates. He could only get a certain amount of days off. And on those days, it was supposed to rain. So, yeah, I mean, like, big time rain. So I wasn't going to mess with that myself. What do you think, pal?
Oh.
Go time.
Yeah.
It's time to eat. It is time to eat.
Oh, that's so warm.
Uh-huh.
That is good.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Spectacular. Oh. Hot, warming you up.
Yeah.
Mm.
Ooh, that's good.
Mm-hmm. We both have bowls, but for convenience tonight, we're just going to eat right out of this bag.
Yeah.
And then turn in. Call it a night.
Yeah.
Tomorrow, maybe before we head off in the morning, I'll talk about our setups here, some of the gear that we're using, talk about the map situation. I have been using a pretty good app on my smartphone here that has really helped us out.
Yeah.
Yeah, so we'll talk about that again tomorrow.
Isn't it good?
It is freaking awesome. Still a little hot, but that's
it
okay.
It is hot. I'm straight up swallowing mine.
Like a duck?
Yeah.
Well, basically the plan is that we're going to hike roughly 20 miles here on the Appalachian Trail. The Appalachian Trail around White Top Mountain, you have to get off of it, and you have to hike a little section of the Virginia Creeper Trail, which is a biking trail, which goes all the way from White Top all the way down into Damascus. So we're not going to get back onto the Appalachian Trail. Huh. We are going to hike the Virginia Creeper 10 miles straight downhill. It's very calm. It's super nice.
Oh,
yeah, it follows good. The river. It's absolutely gorgeous. Tons of train trestles that will cross over.
Yeah.
It is an awesome hike. It's a fantastic bike ride. Come to Damascus. You have to ride it. It's well worth it. Trust me. That's the plan.
Yeah.
Yep. We'll finish up our hike. We'll give Susie a call, tell her, hey, we're ready, come get us whenever you can. We didn't have a vehicle parked or anything. And when we get into Damascus, it's time to go out to eat.
Yes.
Cheeseburgers for the guys.
That'll yeah. be the best.
Heck, I might even go to the town bar and grab a beer.
Oh.
That sounds pretty good to me.
Yeah.
Damascus is a trail town. You have the Virginia Creeper, and you have the Appalachian Trail. So the entire economy is set up around those trails. So we'll go to town, get some good food.
Yeah.
Yeah. Take our shoes off and just freaking relax.
Yeah.
Because I bet our feet will be barking by then.
Yeah.
The packages here of Mountain House, which you can order, like, say, from Amazon, are 2.5 servings each. But from what I understand, you can go to Walmart, stores like that, and get individual serving sizes. Because, like, one of these is almost too much for one person.
Yeah.
Unless I'm really hungry, I usually can't finish off one of these myself.
Yeah.
But for a situation like this, oh yeah.
Yeah. Devour.
We decided to go to Pop-Tart Town. I don't know about you, buddy, but I'm ready to kick back in the tent.
Yeah.
Yeah. We both have quilts. We're going to cover up, get warm, sleep good, set the alarm for about 6:30 in the morning.
Yeah.
Tomorrow's a big day. We have to make a heck of a push tomorrow. Yeah.
It should be much easier because it's not as uphill.
Yeah, we should start doing a lot of downhill.
Uh-huh.
I love you, buddy.
Mm. Love you.
Love you, ma'am.
Yeah.
Lucas is putting a fresh pair of socks on so he can stay warm tonight.
Yes.
Nothing is worse than going to bed with socks that are wet with sweat. Oh my gosh, it's terrible. Now with these socks here, we will hang these up and let them dry tonight. Also let them dry tomorrow on the outside of our pack. And then tomorrow night, when we're hopping inside of the tent, we put those socks back on.
Alright.
Yep. Alternate.
Yeah.
Alright. Well. It is bedtime for these guys here.
Yeah.
Gosh, it feels good.
Yeah, it's so warm.
It is really cold out there, but this feels great.
Yeah.
So, yep, the plan is for 6:30, get up. I'll set an alarm here in just a little bit, charge the phone. I'll see you in the morning, man.
All right. Oh, my God.
Gosh, good Lord. Guys, did you hear that crack?
All right, all right, all right, all right.
Hi. All right.
Oh, my gosh.
Want to try that again?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm trying to... I'm not gonna lie. I can't stop laughing.
Oh, jeez. All right. All right, everybody. Good night, everyone.
Good night.
Good night. Good morning, everybody.
Yeah.
Say good morning, Rokey.
Good morning.
All right. Guys, it is... No. What time is it? 7 o'clock?
Yeah, right about that.
Yeah. Yep. The alarm did not go off on our phones for some reason. That's okay. Yeah. It's still pretty dark out, actually.
Yeah.
And you guys can hear, listen to this. Those winds are rocking and rolling out there.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're still pretty sheltered, but it is windy.
Yeah.
Oh, man. How'd you sleep, buddy?
Pretty good. I fell asleep pretty fast, but I had a lot of trouble just waking up.
Yeah.
but that's how it goes, really.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Yep. It took a while for me to fall asleep.
Yeah.
Woohoo, but once I did, slept good.
Yeah.
Feel good this morning. No aches, pains.
Yeah, I feel good, too.
Yeah. It's about time to put our jackets on, face the breeze, because it's breezy.
Yeah. It's gonna be chilly.
Yeah. Yeah, have some breakfast. You ready for some breakfast?
Oh, yeah. I think when you're camping, you're ready for any food.
Just all the time.
Yeah.
Yep, I hear that. Man, that spaghetti last night was great.
Yeah. Oh, it's so good. I was dreaming about it.
We finished that bag of spaghetti off in just like no time at all.
Yeah.
This is what it looks like from the inside of our tent looking out.
Whew, good morning, folks. Outside of the tent, finally. Chilly up here with this breeze. Yeah, we're basically going to break down camp, get our bags packed, then have some breakfast. Oh yeah. Now, last night we were listening to some tunes on our phones. My son, he would play a song, and then I would play a song. And we, so far this morning, we have both been humming the Stacy's Mom song. Stacy's mom has got it going on. Something like that. Well, he starts singing it, and he starts doing this crazy dance thing. And it's kind of like, Stacy's mom has got it going on. Something like that. It was weird. What do you have to say about yourself there, buddy?
It didn't go down like that.
What? What on earth?
He is...
What it is,
a dancer.
What it is. No, I'm not. What it is I'm cold.
Yeah.
Stacy's mom.
I don't know why I'm punching Stacy's mom.
Yeah, that's aggressive, Dad.
Yeah. Pack it up.
Lucas, we picked an awesome spot, man.
It's so pretty.
It is. Golly.
As you can see, it is beautiful out. It's gonna be a really nice day. Here, come stick your hands around this. Oh, yeah. Stick them lower down here.
Oh.
Feel that heat?
Yeah.
Oh, for breakfast, Mountain House. This is the breakfast skillet. We have hash browns and scrambled eggs mixed with pork sausage patty, peppers and onions.
Ow!
That sounds good.
Yeah. Going to mix some coffee after this and some hot chocolate for the boy. Large Ziploc bag for garbage. It also does a good job of sealing in odor. The sun is coming up over the horizon. We have some hot chocolate. We have some coffee.
Yeah.
We have some breakfast. Something nice and warm to hold on to, thank God.
Yeah. It is cold.
You know, the temperatures aren't that bad. It's probably like 35 or something or other, but it is windy up here. It is really, really windy.
Yeah.
So it's my thoughts that we're going to be out in the wind quite a bit this morning.
Yeah.
As we're walking over these balds here.
Yeah.
We're going to be a little wind blown.
Yeah.
Mmm. Oh, man. Whew, coffee is awesome. How's your hot chocolate?
Ooh, that's good.
Your chocolate that's hot.
Chocolate that is hot.
No beef stick in it this time, huh?
No beef stick.
Yeah. Chocolate without beef stick is a good thing.
Yeah.
Coffee without beef stick is a good thing.
Anything without beef stick.
Agreed.
Any liquid without beef stick is a good thing.
Okay, so while we're sitting here having breakfast, drinking some coffee, let's talk about navigation. Maps, GPS, so on and so forth. Before I left the house, I gathered all sorts of information on this trip here. I found a guide for hiking northbound on the AT. We are hiking southbound. So essentially what we're doing here is just reverse following these instructions. And really, I printed this out so that I know where the water sources are,
because
everything else is pretty explanatory here on the AT. For the most part, the trails are labeled, they're flagged with the white blazes very, very well.
So, but yeah, this has some like GPS coordinates to like water, stuff like that. Make things nice and easy. So I have that little bit of information. Now, what I have here are some topographical maps. And essentially what I've done, I've printed them front and back. So we started here. We are actually right about here. We're right before the Thomas Knob Shelter, right? So once we get over here, I could just take this map and flip it around backwards, and it carries on. Ready to rock and roll. Yeah. I have a compass here just in case I need it. It's pretty cool. With the Thomas Knob Shelter, that is one of about 250 shelters on the Appalachian Trail.
Oh,
yeah. Each shelter is roughly 15 miles apart.
Wow.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
Okay. On the phone, folks. On the phone. I have been using an app that has turned out to be fantastic. And it's called All Trails. And essentially, I did a search for Appalachian Trail, this area, pulled it up. Then it uses the GPS, tags you exactly where you are on that map. There we go. Hopefully you guys can see that. Little blue mark, that's where we are at right now. So right before Thomas Knob Shelter, dude.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I also have the GPS unit, which we really haven't been using, but I'm recording the trek. So I record these treks and then I put them on my computer, and that way I kind of have a memory. I can go back and look at everything I've done. Yeah, so we are in really good shape. Today's a big day.
Yeah.
We've got to really pound out the miles.
Yeah.
Yep. Definitely do.
Yeah.
It's going to be awesome. So we have actually two more shelters to go. Let's see. There's the Thomas Knob Shelter. There's another shelter, but I can't remember the name of it right now, right off the top of my head. There's a third shelter, which we will go around, but not actually go to. That's the Saunders Shelter.
Yeah.
We're going to be on the Creeper Trail by then.
Ah.
Yep. We'll skip it.
So are we going to reach the Creeper Trail today, or would that be one Wednesday? Because
I'm thinking probably Wednesday.
Yeah.
Creeper Trail Wednesday.
Because then we just come out.
Yep. It really depends on just how fast we go today.
Yeah.
Yesterday was slow.
Yeah.
There's a lot of uphill. We did a lot of rock scrambling.
Yeah.
And to be honest, we got a little bit lost at one point. And we had to backtrack a little bit and find the White Blazes again, because there's numerous trails up there. And we started taking one thinking that it was something else.
Yeah.
And we had to backtrack, found the AT again. And that All Trails map app for the phone helped us out bigly.
Yeah.
Thank you, Donald Trump, for that word. Bigly. It sounds made up, but it is a real word. I looked it up.
Yeah.
Bigly. Bigly. That's awesome. That map program for the phone,
uh-huh.
All Trails, it's a free app, has really come in handy.
Yeah.
Very awesome. Bon appetit. Oh, yeah.
Is it good?
That is a breakfast scramble, dude.
Is it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
I'm scrambling for some breakfast scramble.
For some scrambled breakfast.
It looks like someone went into a kitchen and cooked up a mighty fine breakfast. Then they put it in a bag and, like, beat the hell out of it with a stick.
Yeah.
And then gave it to you to eat.
Yeah, like blended it.
Yeah. It may look weird, but it doesn't change the flavor combo, and that's pretty good.
Yeah.
What do you think?
It's pretty good.
Yeah. Elevation, 5,382 feet. We've gone 4.5 miles first day. Not bad, since we had about 2 hours of light.
Yeah.
We ended up stopping before it got dark, so we can actually set up and all that stuff. Lucas had planned on doing a fire, but there's just not enough wood around here. This place is highly trafficked, dude.
Yeah.
Trafficked. It's highly trafficked. So, just not a whole lot of extra wood laying around.
Yeah.
Our next stop will be the Thomas Knob Shelter. We need to get water, which is behind the shelter, about 150 yards behind it.
Yeah.
So we're going to go fill up our water.
Yeah.
Yep, rock and roll.
Heck yeah.
Whenever we stop for lunch, we'll tell you guys about our backpacks, our loadouts, weight, all that stuff.
Yeah.
Pack's on. Let's go.
Let's do it.
Oh my gosh. This pack is so lightweight.
Is it?
Yeah, it is. Gosh, when you have no water.
Yeah.
Super light.
What an amazing view, Bal.
Yeah, for real.
Wow, Lucas.
Wow.
That is spectacular, buddy.
Yeah.
Hi, bird. Hi, buddy. Oh, he's singing to us.
Yeah.
Thank you for sharing your songs with us this morning.
I don't know about you, buddy, but I find that very special.
Yeah.
I mean, he's singing to us. He's not even flying away.
Yeah.
Life is good.
Yeah.
Life is good.
Thomas Knob Shelter. Wow, this is cool. Cool.
Yeah.
No one's here. Thomas Knob Shelter.
Yeah, open up that Ziploc bag.
Gotta leave a message for everybody else.
Yep.
What does it say in there?
Jenny, good to be back on the trail. Ruined my life in the most beautiful way.
That's awesome. I feels period, young blood, happy to finally make it back to this section for the first time since my through. Just day hiking on my way down to G Hostel to work for the next month. Then, CDT. Happy trails, class of 2017. Wow, this guy's doing some serious backpacking.
Yeah.
AT 15, PCT 16, CDT 17. Now the guy that we talked to yesterday evening, he said that there was people here last night. So is today the 21st?
I think so. I'm not too sure.
Okay. Folks, this is the Thomas Knob Shelter. I have written a secret message inside of this book here. So you guys have to come check it out to read it, to know what I wrote.
Yeah.
Now, inside of this bag is some extra food. There's some ramen noodles and some sort of dehydrated something or other. Not interested. Are you?
Nah.
Nope. Then
I'm full.
They left some clothes there. Ditching some weight is pretty much what they were doing.
Yeah.
Let's see. What do we got? Is it just a shirt or is it a pair of pants or what? It's a shirt of some sort.
Yeah.
Yep. Dickies. It's a Dickies shirt, some socks, a stuffed sack, lots of socks.
All right, over here, pal. That's where we're going.
Okay.
See that blue mark on the rock?
Yeah.
That signifies water.
Woo!
Come up here and enjoy the breeze, buddy.
Down there to get some water.
All right.
So where's this water at? We know it's down here somewhere.
Yeah.
Here it is.
Water.
Beautiful. Right out of the ground, bro.
Wow.
Right out of the ground.
Nice.
Now for this trip here, we are using Aquamira drops to sterilize our water. I thought about bringing a filter, but I decided against it. Drops are really, really easy. Before you take this out, check those bottles first. Also, make sure it's still in date. So this will treat 1 liter with 7 drops of A, 7 drops of B. Let that sit for about 5 minutes.
Okay. Nothing to it. Very easy.
One, two, three.
We'll let this sit for about 5 minutes. It'll change colors. We'll dump it into each bag from there.
All right, buddy. We are all watered up.
Yep.
Yes, sir. Go ahead and turn around here, and I'll tell everybody what we did.
All right.
So for his drinking bag right here, we used the Aquamira drops so he can start drinking in about 15 minutes. Here with his water bottle, we used tablets. So this will be ready to go in 30 minutes. That way we don't have to sit here and wait for the part A and part B to activate.
So I basically did the same thing. Make sure we didn't leave anything behind. Let's go.
All right.
We got some miles to do.
Yep.
Whew. I'm ready to get out of this wind. I mean, it's starting to warm up nicely.
Yeah.
But there's a nip to it.
Yeah.
You know what I always found amazing?
What?
Like, that spring is coming right out of the top of this mountain.
Yeah.
Water is coming out at the top of the mountain. That doesn't make any sense.
Uh-uh.
I don't know how that works.
Yeah.
I'm just glad it does.
Yep.
So Lucas, what did we find?
We have a bathroom.
Yes, we do.
Yeah.
We have a privy.
Let's get these miles in, buddy.
Yeah.
I am looking forward to hiking the Creeper Trail tomorrow.
Me too. Nice and flat.
Yeah.
You see up there on top of the ridge, all those dead trees?
Uh-huh.
Those are hemlock trees.
Ah.
Yeah, they're all dying out.
Yeah. Coyote poop.
Yeah.
Is it poop?
It sure is. Coyote scat.
Yeah.
Fairly old, though. So we got some signs here. Appalachian Trail, Elk Ridge, or Elk Garden, that's where we're going. Ah, this is the Mount Rogers Summit. This is the highest peak here in Virginia.
Yeah.
I would say go up there, but the views aren't very good.
Yeah, that's the only downfall, I think.
Yeah, following the white blaze.
Yeah.
All right, folks, looking at the sky here, we're just stopping to take off some layers, but do you guys believe in chemtrails? Let's go full conspiracy theory. What do you guys think? Because here in the sky, I mean, there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, at least 17 chemtrails in the sky. Or maybe they're not chemtrails, whatever you want to say they are. I'm not really sure. What do you guys think? Do you guys believe that this is a chemtrail thing, that they're trying to cool down the atmosphere, or doing something else? What do you guys think? Comment down below, share your thoughts. The thing is that it's still a little bit chilly with the breeze here, but it was too warm with those additional layers on, so we were actually sweating even though we were comfortable. It's better to be somewhat chilly and not sweat. Keep as much of that hydration as possible. That's definitely the way to go. I'll tell you, folks, I'm having so much fun. I really am. I'm having a great time being with my boy. I mean, this is amazing, pal.
Yeah, it's a lot
of fun. Yep, it is.
Check out this environment.
Really neat.
I mean, couldn't you imagine, like, a big black bear crashing through the forest? Perfect black bear environment.
Yeah.
It has been a while since I've seen a black bear on the AT. I think the last one that I saw on the Appalachian Trail was 2015, which was awesome. He came scurrying down this tree as I was hiking through, and he was growling, making all sorts of noises and stuff. Oh, it's cool. I love it. Now for this trip here, Lucas and I, we are not carrying a whole lot of water. We each have around 2 liters each. This area has so much water, in fact, that it's just not that big of a deal. There's water everywhere. I've heard of some people actually hiking this part with only a liter of water.
Now, Lucas, in that shelter in the book, was it Jenny? Was that her name?
Yeah.
Yeah, she said that. Jenny. Yeah, she said that the AG had ruined her life in the most wonderful way. What do you think exactly that meant? Like, you think she lost like a relationship because of it, or a job, or something? Or?
Yeah, I'm sure she's probably been out here so much that her life outside of hiking has
crumbled.
Yeah.
Probably.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
I'll tell you what, folks, being out for a long period of time, it's very special. You know, it's like a, not to sound too metaphorical or whatever, but it's like a window to the soul, you know? You can see what your strengths are, you can see what your weaknesses are. Essentially, you'll discover who you really are when you step away from all the crap that you filled your life with. And I'm talking about like television and computers and electronics. It's funny how we all work to buy these things that are almost pointless. We fill our lives with it, all these doodads, all these things. The question is, do they really matter? I don't know. I don't think so. Not in the grand scope of things. I have to say that since I've been out backpacking, I'm not missing anything right now. How about you, Lukey?
Nope, just my bird.
Yep, missing his bird.
Check this out, folks. This is pretty cool. At one point in time, this was a massive tree. That is really neat.
Yeah.
Wow. This is where we are headed. Up, up, and more up. How's that, dude?
It's it.
Not very pleased with it?
It's just hard.
Yeah, but you're doing great. We'll just stop, take a breather. Anytime you need it.
All right.
Here you go.
Thank you. You think it's good now?
Yep. Woo, I am ripe. I am ripe. I stink, he don't. We are actually going around Mount Rogers right now. That's Mount Rogers.
Mm-hmm.
Right up here was the trail to go up to it. Mm. So we are right about here. We're about to start heading up, up the mountain, go around the ridge of Mount Rogers.
Mm-hmm.
So we started here. We camped out right about there on the map. And right now we are right about here. Hopefully you guys can see that. Mount Rogers is right here, and we are circumventing that. We're going around it. You know, with these maps here, I basically did a screenshot. I went online, did a search for some topographical Appalachian Trail maps. If you had the version that was paid for, it had like everything listed, like this shelter was here, this mountain is this, and so on.
Mm-hmm.
And I essentially just took screenshots of the basic map and went back and filled in where the like shelters are, which mountain is what, stuff like that.
Yeah.
So, yeah, super easy, saved a lot of money. I have backup maps if I need them.
Yeah.
Yeah.
How do your feet feel?
Pretty good. Yours?
Yeah.
Yeah? Having any issues?
No, just I feel it in my foot, like right here.
Ah, like in the arch or something?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep.
I hear you.
Mm-hmm.
When we stop for lunch, we'll take our shoes off, let our puppies air out a little bit.
Yeah.
Yeah, that'll feel good.
Mm-hmm.
It's always a good idea to keep your shoes snug. You don't want them overly tight, but you don't want them loose either. Your toes will compensate if your shoe is loose, and they'll kind of dig into the ground a little bit, and that's one element that will cause blisters on the bottoms of your toes as they're trying to push into the ground and try to give you some traction. So have your shoes snug. You don't want them too tight because you don't want them cutting off circulation to your feet either.
Cool spot, amigo.
Yeah.
I really like this rock here. Look at that gnarly looking tree growing on top of it.
That's crazy.
And it is gnarly looking.
Yeah.
That is so wicked.
Going around Mount Rogers now, the highest point here in Virginia, making our way to Buzzard Rock. Update time, folks. We are approaching the 8 mile mark. So, it's been about an hour and a half
And we've done basically the same amount of mileage that we did yesterday. Man, we are hauling. We're doing really good. With our hiking so far, we've had one tumble. Lucas took a spill. Luckily, he was able to catch himself nice and easy. Didn't even hurt his paws, his hands. So, thumbs up. Earlier, Lucas and I were talking about trail magic. And trail magic is very, very special. And it doesn't come along often. But when it does, there's nothing like it. There really isn't. Now, an example of trail magic is back there at that shelter where the food was. Now, someone's going to be hiking up from Damascus. They're going to be tired. They're going to be hungry. And they're going to see that food. Somebody is, right? They're going to see that food and they're going to be like, oh my gosh, I want to eat this so bad. I'm so tired of whatever it is. Or maybe they're running low on food. Whatever it may be, that is going to be trail magic for someone. Maybe they've worn a hole in their socks and the extra clothes that are laying there. Trail magic. I know I've told this story before, but I was backpacking with a friend of mine in the Pisgah National Forest, and it was right towards the end of our hike. We're coming down from this mountain. We were sopping wet because we've been hiking in a thunderstorm all morning long, like 4 hours, nothing but rain. And here comes this car racing up this mountain, and the guy stops right next to us, puts the window down, and he's like, you guys look like you could use a cold beer. And we were like, hell yeah. And that was the best beer I have ever had in my entire life. That is trail magic right there. I see you strutting your stuff. Keep going, dude. Kind of looks like a Sasquatch wearing a backpack and some pants.
All right, Dad, you strut.
Okay, let's see. I'll pretend I have a cane. That's all I got, man. That's me strutting my stuff. Okay, I am ready to go uphill, dude.
Yep.
I'm cold.
Me too.
It is colder down here than it was on top of that mountain.
Yeah.
We've probably gone down a good 700 feet. And, yeah, it's definitely colder here. Mm-hmm. Windy as heck.
Yeah.
Gosh, those trees are rocking back and forth. But, let's see, we're at 4,900 feet right now. So we've descended quite a bit. What do you see?
Look at that cool tree.
Growing right on top of this rock, supporting itself with these two legs here. Hey. Woo! Hey, little woolly worm.
You're a cute guy.
You gonna pick him up?
Should I?
Sure, go ahead.
Come here, little dude.
Well, you have a new pet. Hold on to him good.
All right.
Well, maybe you should put him back
I'd
down.
I'd probably take you down, little buddy.
Yep. Looks like he was going someplace.
Yeah. You want up back on your rock?
9.5 miles. Total. We are at 4,600 feet. Wow. It's gorgeous out here.
Yeah.
Time for an opening. Nice. Real nice. We're about to come across the White Top Road. Over this direction, we have the Elk Garden Trail. They will merge at the road. Incredibly windy. What a spot, buddy.
Yeah.
Lots of coyote poop.
Yeah.
It's everywhere. Gosh, with these winds rocking about 30 miles an hour, temperatures in the 50s, it's chilly up here.
Yeah.
Check this out. Hours ago, about 9 o'clock, we were up there at that bog.
Wow.
That's where we got water at.
Progress.
That's pretty cool. Elk Garden.
This is White Top Road.
Since there's a bathroom here, guys, going to go inside, use the bathroom, why not, and get rid of some garbage. I have about half a pound of trash, which I'm going to unload here. Heck yeah. Yeah.
Just a quick snack to tide us over till lunch. Once we get out of this wind, we'll fire up the stove, have some soup.
Yeah.
Yeah, some corn chowder.
Ooh.
Oh yeah.
Wind free, back into the wind. Wind free, back into it.
Cool place here. I love the moss growing on this rock, man. Cool spot to have lunch, man.
Yeah.
Right under this gigantic boulder.
It's cool.
It is cool.
All right, guys, it is time for some lunch. We are boiling some water here. What we have is some easy, quick, and healthy, creamy, good corn chowder. One of the viewers sent this in to us, an entire box of Harmony House foods. So, yeah, we're gonna start off by splitting one of these, see how it goes. Yeah, we have more of these. It takes about 15 minutes to cook this, so yeah, we might eat one and just have a snack. I might have to put on a long sleeve. I'm cold. How about you, buddy?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm pretty cold.
That's funny. It's like we're using some water here that we treated with some tablets. I mean, it looks like we're boiling a cup of pee-pee. A cup of urine. A cup of That's going to make for some delicious, creamy, good corn chowder. Oh, it smells awesome, dude.
Really?
Yeah.
Ooh,
what do you think of that?
It's good.
Okay.
Strangely yellow.
It is strangely yellow.
Looks pretty good.
Oh yeah. I'm gonna turn the heat down so it can simmer. I just put my jacket over my chest rig. Speaking of the chest rig, this is a ribs pack. As you can see here, Lucas has one too. These are awesome packs. Make carrying like the gear that you need to grab in a pinch real quickly very simple. Very lightweight, lots of space. They rock. What do you think about them?
I agree.
Yeah.
It's very handy. You have like four different items in there and they're all easy to get.
Right.
Yep.
That's it, man. Now, I told you before that we would talk about the backpacks and our weight, our loadout here. We went ultra light for this trip.
Yeah.
Each one of our packs come in at 15 pounds. Since we've been eating food, we're probably down to about 14, 13 something or other. Yeah. That includes food and water. So, very lightweight.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, you could pick these packs up and toss them. They're that light. So, that really has helped with this trip. The uphill, the downhill,
yeah,
on the shoulders, it's not bad.
Uh-huh.
Yep. By the time we get done with this trip, we'll probably have, like, I don't know, 11-pound, 12-pound packs.
Yeah.
That's pretty awesome.
Yeah.
Now, of course, we could have gone even lighter weight if we wanted to. We have kit bags just like this. We could have ditched those. We could have left some of the additional gear at home. We could have saved probably another 2 pounds.
Yeah.
If we wanted to.
Yeah.
Yeah. I tell you what, man, for me, this trip is exactly what I needed.
Yeah.
Yeah. I needed to get away, recharge the batteries through Mother Nature.
Yeah. Yeah, this is great.
Yeah. It's awesome, man.
Yeah.
To John. John sent us all this soup here. Thank you so much, buddy. We really, really appreciate it. Big time.
Yeah.
Oh man, that does look pretty good.
Yeah.
Show you guys what this looks like. Yeah, so there you go. Some corn chowder.
Never had corn chowder.
Oh no?
Uh-uh.
This isn't the typical corn chowder.
Yeah?
That I'm used to.
Oh, made me cry. That is good.
It is good.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's not like really creamy like you would expect with like a chowder, like a corn chowder.
Yeah.
It's like subtle, but it's really good. You have the onions,
yeah,
and the corn in there mixed with the crackers is pretty epic.
Yeah, mix your thing together and it looks creamy.
Oh yeah. It is
freezing cold.
It are is. You cold? I'm shaking.
Gosh, it is so day windy.
Yeah.
It's amazing.
I can't help but shake.
Now, as we've been sitting here, number of backpackers going down. Gosh, one guy, he looked like he was carrying... He looked like he was a Sherpa.
Yeah.
It looked like he was carrying like the load for like five people.
Yeah.
I don't know what...
It yeah. looked like he had like three sleeping bags on the outside of his backpack. I'm not sure what was going on there.
Yeah.
But...
A lot.
Yeah. I noticed that they kept stopping every so many feet. Maybe that's why.
Yeah.
It's too much weight. Okay, so... Okay, guys. So we are... Let's see. Essentially, actually, we are right here. We just went across... White Top Mountain Road, and we are going to continue down. It's 2 miles to White Top, right there. Now, we are not heading up to White Top. We're going to skip that, and we're going to Buzzard Rock. Yep. Then, we start going around Beach Mountain.
Whoa.
Yeah. It's not bad, pal.
Yeah.
It's not bad at all.
Uh-uh.
I've been working with Lucas here on how to read topographical maps. So,
man, you're pretty good at it.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's constantly like... I'm always like, oh, you think we'll have to go up that? He's like, no, we're going around it. He's like, he knows already. Smart.
Taught me well.
Yeah, smart boy. All right, guys. See ya on the trail. We continue hiking on.
Yeah.
Making our way around White Top, then we'll be heading to Beach Mountain. It's about 1 o'clock in the afternoon. We got roughly 4 or 5 hours left of hiking for the day. Yeah, we'll be right at the 20 mile mark once we call it done for this evening. That's pretty sweet, guys. That is sweet.
Tell the viewers, how are you?
Doing good.
Yeah?
Yeah, it's hard going up.
It is.
This mountain.
You always have to go uphill to go down.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah.
So. I'm thinking, I think about 30 minutes or so.
Yeah.
I think we'll be heading downhill.
Probably so. That's sweet.
Yeah.
That is very cool.
So cool, man. So cool.
Yeah. Oh man, what a beautiful spot to camp, dude. All right, taking a quick breather. Lucas is going to dig out some energy chocolate out of his backpack. This stuff rocks. One of our viewers sent this in, and we've been buying it, searching for it all over the place. It's a German product, chocolate with caffeine in it. 6 pieces is the equivalent to a cup of coffee. We'll have 3 each. What do you think?
Yeah, half a cup.
Yeah.
Ooh. Thanks for the chocolate.
Yeah.
Mm. That's good. Yeah. I'll tell you what, I'll stick it in my pocket here. And we'll hit up pieces as we hike.
Mm.
What do you think?
Yeah. Ooh.
Mm-hmm. That's good. Mm-hmm. That chocolate rocks, man.
So good.
Mm.
Hey, I think it's time for a little bit of pool water.
Mine is much yellower than his.
Yeah.
Mine's really dark.
It's pretty gross looking.
Yeah, it is. Check this out, folks. Look at this. The pack is so light, you can just pick it up with one arm, throw it on.
We're going this way?
Yep.
Okay, Lucas.
Yeah.
We have to come up with a trail name for you, buddy. Like, you have tripped and fallen many times during this adventure. What do you think?
Yeah, I've been pretty clumsy. I'm trying.
What do you think about Captain Trips?
Captain Trips.
Yeah,
I think your
that works.
Your trail name should be Captain Trips.
I can't stay steady.
Huh? Oh, that's awesome.
Okay, so that's his trail name, Captain Trips. You like that one?
Yeah.
Okay.
Captain
I think
Trips.
It's a pretty cool.
Yeah.
And I am, of course, Greybush. And I cannot explain to you why. Ah, come back out there. Don't go down there, yo. You guys, what's up with that?
All right, cross the road, here we go.
Let's do it.
Cool, man.
Yeah.
Wow. The view here is pretty epic, even on this hazy day. That is just so beautiful.
Yeah.
Look at those mountains. What do you think about that, bud?
Really pretty.
Oh, man. Amazing.
Yeah. Great world.
Yeah, no doubt. All you have to do is go out and look.
Yep.
It's all around you.
Yeah. You know, I feel bad for the people who don't get out and go explore. I feel bad for the people who don't get to see this and get to experience this.
This is the spring of varying flow, isn't
yeah.
it?
Yeah, for real.
Yeah.
Very slow, mild.
Yep. All right, getting ready.
And boom!
Lucas is the one who spotted this spring, had the good idea to stop, fill up. We dropped some tablets into our bottles.
Yeah.
Dropping the tablets in. Worry about it later.
Yeah, so we essentially came down from here through the woods over.
Hey,
here we are.
Boom.
Wide open spaces, baby.
Look at that view. Guys, we are making freaking awesome progress.
Yeah.
We were looking at the map a little bit back there, and by the time it gets dark, we will be that close from the Virginia Creeper Trail, which is exactly what we want. Tomorrow, we want to be able to hop on the Virginia Creeper, walk in the rain.
Yeah.
Oh, dude.
That will be great.
Yeah, gentle downhill in the rain. That's going to be awesome.
Yeah.
How about that?
Wow, that's crazy.
That's eye-opening, isn't it?
Wow.
Alright, folks, here's the view. One in a million.
Truly.
Wow. Pretty spectacular, buddy.
Yeah.
So here we are, continuing on. Buzzard Rock was freaking amazing, wasn't it?
Yeah.
That's awesome.
That was incredible.
We're way past Buzzard Rock now, continuing on. We are going around Beach Mountain. So we have another hour or so of this, then we'll be coming out on Jeb Road. I think there is another road that we might actually cross over, like a gravel road or something or other. I don't know. Yeah, Beach Mountain Road, I think. Loving this downhill. Lucas is loving the downhill too. It is just fantastic.
Whew, guys. Break time.
Yep.
I am a bit rank, to be honest with you. I stink.
Yeah.
Whew.
Yeah.
Smell like a true hiker. This has been steady downhill.
Yeah.
We have lost a lot in altitude.
Yeah. It hurts.
This is beating our feet and our knees to death.
Yeah.
It's so rocky, so it's just...
Yeah.
Pow on your knees. With some girls. Let's see. We are going around Beach Mountain now.
Mm-hmm.
We are on page 4 out of 5. And
wow.
Number 5 is basically just the creeper trail into town. So, yeah, we are right about here on this map. Creeper trail starts right here. We'll be there in a couple hours.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Awesome.
We're really going quick. We still have to go past Beach Mountain Road.
Mm-hmm.
And then, then we have Jeb Stewart Highway.
Past that.
Yep.
Little ways.
Yep. Then we have, towards the end, something called Grassy Ridge Road, which is probably a gravel road. Once we get past Jeb Stewart Highway, we'll be coming up on the Lost Mountain Shelter.
Ooh.
If no one's there, maybe we should spend the night there tonight.
Yeah.
Good. Don't even set up the tent. Just sleep inside.
Yeah. That'd be cool.
Good.
Yeah.
We'll see.
Okay.
It'll definitely be getting dark by the time we hit that point.
Yeah.
Sick. Hit up some more water.
Yeah.
Time to start moving again. Pretty good snack. We ended up having a Pop-Tart. That was awesome.
Yeah.
Man.
Those are great.
Yeah. When you're on the trail, anything tastes good.
Yeah. Especially urine.
Super yellow water. Got some miles to do. Woo! I think the plan for the night is to head to Lost Mountain Shelter, I believe. So that's our goal. Hopefully we'll have it to ourselves. Stay in there, don't even have to worry about setting up the tent because it is supposed to rain tonight. So, if it's going to rain, walking out tomorrow without carrying a heavy, wet tent, thumbs up. You could shave a pound off your pack by not having a wet tent.
You see this tree right over here with that growth on it?
Uh-huh.
That is called a burl.
Huh.
Yep. Essentially, it's like a tree tumor.
Yeah, that's what it looks like.
It doesn't kill the tree.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. I've seen where, like, artists have, like, I guess trees that have died have uh-huh. taken those things and, like, sanded them down, make them really smooth. They are beautiful.
Huh. That'd be cool.
Yeah. Lucas pretty much called it. He said that we would be getting close to the road here, and he is right. This is the Beach Mountain Road. That is a beautiful area over there.
Yeah.
I don't know how well you guys are going to be able to see this, but it's pretty awesome.
All right. Let's go, buddy.
Let's do it.
This push up to Lost Mountain Shelter is a good one.
Yeah, it's difficult.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Tell you what, he is handling this like a pro, like a champ. I mean, he's been leading the way. He's been the captain of this trip. Captain trips. Anyway, I'm so clever.
Yeah.
But, yeah, he's leading the way. I have to walk full speed to keep his stride. It's those long legs, man. those freakishly long legs.
Freakishly.
Yeah. No average person's over 5'5", man. Nobody, dude. Anything over that's
What, Titan?
You're a Titan, yeah. The shelter is right over here somewhere. We are very, very close. Should be there in 5 minutes.
Coming up on Lost Mountain Shelter. Look at all the hikers.
Ooh, yeah. Okay, well, time for plan B.
Yeah.
And that's to find another spot to camp. We are 6 miles to Sanders Shelter, however you want to pronounce it. But we are not going that far because the creeper trail pops up before that shelter. So we're within like 4 miles of the creeper right now. Whew. How many people were back there?
Like 7 people.
Yeah, the shelter was packed.
Yeah.
No bueno. No good. There was tents everywhere. They were in the woods, scattered all over the place. So, right now we are just looking for a place to pitch our tent. A flat spot. Okay, it's getting dark now. Have to have the headlamps on so we can see for roots and rocks. Roots and rocks sticking up. Pretty tired. Lucas and I were very close to the 20 mile mark for today. 20 miles. I was telling Lucas that he's earned his badge for being a backpacker. When you hit the 20 mile a day mark, you've done it. Oh yeah, you're not a camper, you're a backpacker. So we are very, very close to coming out onto, you remember the name of this road?
No.
I don't either. Some road. It's a gravel road. Yeah. And then just a short distance from the Virginia Creeper Trail. Coming out on the road. Take a load off, pal.
Yeah.
I'm going to walk down this road a little bit.
Okay.
Just to see if there's a...
You want me to go?
Nope, stay here.
Okay.
I'll be right back. Keep the camera.
Hold.
I walked down the road and I found this field that had been planted with Christmas trees. But the way that it was sloped, there wasn't a good place to get away from, or there wasn't a good place to get out of sight. So, decided it's best just to keep on going. I don't mind stealth camping, but you have to do it stealthily. You can't be on top of a mountain in a white tent. That doesn't work, does it?
Nope.
All right, so we'll just push on just a little bit further. We'll be out on the Creeper Trail in no time. We can definitely camp on it if we have to. All right, folks, here we go. The Virginia Creeper Trail. Okay. This is number 38. Ooh, smells like a train, don't it?
Yeah.
Need to figure out which way we are heading on this thing. Well, we are going to hike for a bit here. Find a place to camp out.
Yep.
It is time to rest our bones, man. Are you hungry?
Yeah, are you?
I'm a little bit hungry.
Yeah.
I'm so tired that I almost think I could like eat a bar and
that's
just go to bed.
But Chili Mac does sound pretty good.
Oh, Chili Mac does sound way good.
Hey, and I was saving that candy bar for something special. I think this is pretty special.
I think so.
Yeah.
Woo! We'll bring you guys back once we find a place to camp out at.
Yeah.
Here's that train trestle that we walked across. We are going to camp out right here. Right in the middle. Well, not really in the middle of the trail, but right on the side of the trail.
Well, alright. Going to set up the tents. It's dark, you guys won't see anything, so why film? Once we get that set up, then it's time to eat.
Yep.
Oh, man.
Howdy.
Hey.
I am filming here. One tired dude.
Yeah, I'm beat.
Yeah, but you deserve to be.
Yeah, cool.
Guys, tent set up right next to a bench, right next to this plaque, right next to a train trestle. That's awesome.
Yeah.
This is our home for the night. We have our stove rocking and rolling. Oh, we almost decided not to make dinner.
Yeah.
And just to snack on a couple things and hop in bed. But I think we got to finish this night off the right way.
Yeah.
With a good meal.
Yeah.
Going to pop some Aleve before bed.
Yeah.
Yep. How are you feeling? What's bothering you, if anything?
My shoulders are surprisingly the worst. They're so stuck. I don't know.
Right.
Can't move them.
Love it. That is what backpacking is all about. I love the soreness. You know, to me, it's like my badge.
Yeah.
Like, I earned that. You earned it.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't know anybody his age who is going out and hiking 20 miles a day. I mean, we were at Grayson Highlands today.
Yeah. That's crazy, and we're in the Creeper.
Yeah?
Yeah.
That's amazing.
That's crazy.
Yeah, we have gone a long way in a very short period of time.
Yeah.
I'm proud of this guy. Lukey, I am really, really proud of you, buddy.
Thanks.
Yep. Yeah, I mean, he made this fun, made it look easy at the same time. Water is almost there.
All right.
Rain's going to start up tonight. Who knows when? Tomorrow we'll have to put the camera away. We'll have to hike with the GoPro. Don't know how much you guys will see. Yeah. With the course of all that.
Yeah.
I don't know. I don't know. We shall see. All right, guys. Here we go. Since we're waiting on the chili mac to rehydrate, we decided that we're going to go ahead and have dessert first.
Yeah.
Dessert for dinner. We could do that. We walked 20 miles. We could do that.
Yeah. That's fine.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, so what do we got? What is that?
This is an Oreo chocolate candy bar.
Okay. Sounds good.
Mom really found it. Sounds good.
Yeah, we are definitely calorie deficient. That soup that we had for lunch, while good, had very little calories to it.
Yeah, what was it?
It was 21 calories per serving. And it had 4 servings in the package.
Yeah.
Which means that we got 42 calories each, guys. So we had that, the Pop-Tart, the breakfast this morning. So, yeah. Oh yeah, we're way behind.
Yeah. Where's my 2,000?
Yeah, we're way, 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 way off. Oh, that's good.
Mm.
Yeah, Oh man, that is awesome, dude.
Yeah.
Why don't we have a bag full of these?
I don't know.
Yeah, I've never even had one of these, never even heard of it before, but it is awesome. We could probably be licking a cat's butt right now and be like, that's so good.
Yeah.
Yeah, look like that. We're so tired, we can hardly think straight.
You could be licking a cat's butt. Yeah.
Cut.
Yeah.
Cut. Really gonna stop and have lunch tomorrow. We're just gonna snack, stop as we want to. But as soon as we get into Damascus, we are heading straight to the cafe.
Yeah.
Cheeseburgers, French fries. Oh, snap.
That'll be good.
Yep. It's going to be awesome, pal.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Is it good?
Yeah, we are.
Is that spaghetti good?
Mmm. It's like chili with noodles in it.
Huh.
Which is almost like spaghetti.
Yeah.
Dig in, pal.
Okay.
Just don't waste any more time. I'm not going to.
I want all the noodles, dude.
Just the noodles, though.
That's what I'm getting.
I want all the beans. He wants all the noodles.
Win-win.
I guess. Someone's going to lose. All right, guys. I'm too tired to keep on filming. Going to eat, then hop into the tent. See you guys in a bit.
Bye.
All right. We are in for the evening.
Yeah.
Absolutely beat. Again, guys, I am so proud of this man right here. He really did an awesome job today.
Thank you.
Over the last 2 days, you've done great.
Yeah.
Tomorrow's going to be hard.
Yeah.
It's going to be in the rain. We're going to be wet.
Yeah.
Yep. 10 miles to go.
Uh-huh. Not bad.
No. It's going to be a hoot.
Yeah. It'll go fast.
Too. Oh, yeah. It will. All right. Everybody, good night.
Good night.
Oh, good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Yeah. It is very, very humid inside of our tent. It is pouring the rain, as you guys can hear. It is really coming down. We are going to have a very interesting day. There's no doubt about that. We have about 10 miles to go. In the rain, we're gonna put on our rain gear and just go slow so we don't sweat too much, but still make pretty good progress. Mm-hmm. GoPro time, we'll see how well that works. I've only used it like here and there.
Yeah.
Yeah, but yeah, we're gonna have to break down camp inside of the tent. That's gonna be difficult with 2 people.
Yeah.
Possible, but it's gonna be difficult. Wish us luck, everybody.
Yeah, it's gonna be weird.
Yeah, this is gonna be fun. We will wait a while before we hit the road. Let the sun come up. Maybe the rain will slack off just a little bit. We shall see.
Yeah.
But that's the plan. Just kick back and relax for a little while. We'll be right back.
Mr. Lucas.
Yes.
How was that burger, buddy?
It was great.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Super good.
It was the best reward ever.
Dang right.
Yeah.
Well, folks, we have finished our adventure from Grayson Highlands down to Damascus. We've had our awesome cheeseburgers. They were exactly what we needed, what we wanted. Super awesome. We have spent the entire morning hiking in the rain, in the pouring rain. We did about 10 miles downhill on the Virginia Creeper and had a blast doing it.
Yeah.
Yep. That was a ton of fun, wasn't it?
Yeah. It's hard.
Yeah, it was.
Hurt.
Yeah. Yeah.
No doubt about it.
We got permission from the owner here to just hang out on the porch for about an hour and a half before our ride shows up. So, yeah. It's still raining. We thought about hiking into town, but now that we have our rain gear off, the packs off, we don't feel like putting them back on.
Unless you want to put them back on.
That's the last thing I want to do, man.
Okay, well, he's being honest about it. He don't want to do it anymore. I'm done too. Tired. Gonna kick back, going to relax, wait for the ride. Everybody, we want to thank you all for joining us for this overnight adventure. Strength and honor, everybody. Be well. Cheers, everybody. Cheers, Luca. Well, that's weird. Let's do that again.
I heard took a bite.
Kapow! I'll just have to cut that crap out. if it was Susan is here, I'd... scratch. That's strange.
Yeah.
We gotta go see what this is.
Okay, so we have Cinder Block Mountain. I was expecting more than this.
Yeah.
Okay, well, we found it. Cinder Block Mountain.
Pretty good.
In the hips. I think I said like years ago, I told people that I would never do this again.
He did it.
Uh-oh. Mm-hmm. That's good. Mm-hmm. Also known as Guta, that's Guta.
It's Guta, that's good.
Is it known as Guta? Am I making that up?